Trump family. They're great. We pray for them. They brought renewed force to the Conservative Party, and without them, I don't think that the Conservative Party, you know, without him, I don't think the Conservative Party will do as well.
Awesome, awesome. Well, thank you so much. God bless you. God bless you. Now, from what we know so far with the election results that have come in, specifically the state of Florida. Oh, do you have an interview? I'm going to let Liz do an interview, then I'll do some commentary.
Okay. Thank you, Mike. Again, we are live here at the Arizona GOP headquarters. There was just a press conference with Dave Bossi, I believe, and Dr. Kelly Ward. So we are here, and we're just here to interview. We hopped on a flight early this morning. We want to broadcast what the people of Arizona have to say about the current state of the 2020 election. So I'll let you introduce yourself, your name, where you're from, and just a little background.
Yeah, my first name is Ken Kriske. I am from Scottsdale, Arizona, and I came out here to support President Trump and to just support the GOP here in Arizona to find out what's at the bottom of the voting and how long these tabulations are taking. It just doesn't make any sense. I've lived here since 1980, and I have never seen results come in so slow in an election. So is there something wrong? We're not sure, but all indications are that there's some funny business going on here.
Thank you. One second. Let me give a status. We might have Dr. Kelly Ward coming over for an interview in a minute, so just prep for that if you'll be able to. Thank you. Sorry about that. You know, we're always live, unscripted. So were you expecting going into this election that Arizona would have such delays?
No, absolutely not. Not only did I not expect any delays, but I figured that Arizona would handily win by 15 to 20 points. And we've always pretty much been a red state, and we have had a lot of implants from California, which is going to skew it. But I've just always thought that we would be 10 to 15 points ahead. Never thought this would happen.
So in your opinion, what is causing this drastic change? I would have assumed Arizona as well would go red. We've been here for President Trump's rallies. They have just been thousands and thousands of people waiting to see him, showing support for their president. It's blowing my mind right now that this wasn't a landslide victory for President Trump. What do you think is causing this?
I think it's a lot of the states that border California, which we like to call the land of fruits and nuts, and they come here and they bring their liberal agenda. And there's been a huge population surge. When I first moved here in 1980, Phoenix was just under 1 million people. It's over 5 million now. So, you know, a good portion of those are going to be liberals that are coming from California.
And some of the speakers here today were mentioning they had a lot of optimism for President Trump. And it was, when this is all said and done, President Trump will win this election. Do you believe that to be true for the state of Arizona?
I sure hope so. I'm being hopefully optimistic. And we've had, you know, good leadership with Dr. Kelly Ward at the head of our Republican Party. And I know she's working real hard. She's a very, very strong lady, very smart. And hopefully she'll be able to legally deliver the votes for President Trump.
When you say legally, what do you think is the correct system to go back and recount these votes? What do you want them to do? What do you think is the best option, I suppose, for them to do?
I think all we could do is audit every vote and make sure that they're done correctly, and the correct votes, whether they're for Biden or Trump, they count. And if something does not work according to state law and the way it's supposed to be, then, you know, we should throw those out.
Do you think with the current tabulations that there's been fraud in the state of Arizona?
All I know is this, is every minute that ticks by is more opportunity to bring in a bushel full of baskets that are for Biden. That's all I have to say. And this, like I said, I've been here since 1980. I had my first voting experience here in Arizona for Ronald Reagan. And I've never experienced a delay like this. It's kind of ridiculous.
It's absolutely insane. Final question. You mentioned that you were at President Trump's first ever rally, which was here in Phoenix, Arizona.
Yes, it was.
So you've kind of been following his campaign for a while now. How would you say the overall support is for the state?
Oh, I would have to say from the very first rally to the last one that I went to, the enthusiasm level and support has been greater every time. I mean, President Trump has got a lot of people and patriots that love him. And it shows in his rallies. And you guys know that just from what you feel and going out and how fun everybody is. And I want to just let everybody know I'm going to run. Yeah. But tonight here in Phoenix at 8 p.m., at the Capitol, there's going to be a huge rally with Mike Cernovich. So come out and let's support our President Trump and let's show him love.
Absolutely. Thank you, Ken.
Thank
we
you.
Will be the main news network covering that event live tonight with Mike Cernovich. So he was a wonderful interview. Looks like we have one more with Mike. And then I believe Kelly Ward is coming up for an interview. So we'll be timely.
Yeah, thank
on
you.
That.
Yes, we will. So right now we are joined by Ryan Hartwig, who was one of the whistleblowers on Project Veritas. How long ago was that?
Yeah, that was 4 months ago. I went public with Project Veritas as an insider. So I blew the whistle at Facebook. I filmed with a hidden camera here in Phoenix, actually. I worked as a content moderator. And so what I filmed, I gave that to Congressman Matt Gaetz, and that led to a criminal referral to the DOJ for Mark Zuckerberg for alleged perjury in Congress. And so, that's what I did 4 months ago. I've been continuing to speak out about censorship, big tech censorship, Twitter, Facebook. I'm here in Arizona. I live here in Arizona. I worked on Election Day here in Phoenix, and I was at a poll campaigning for someone, for Marissa Hamilton for mayor, and they moved they have that 75-foot marker, and they moved it 20 feet farther away. So it made it harder for me to talk to people. So that's what happened. That's what happened on Tuesday, on Election Day. So yeah, we're here in Arizona, and
Sorry, we'll come back to this interview. We're going to interview. She's finishing up some pictures.
All right, thank you. We are waiting. Stand by to hear from Arizona Chairwoman Dr. Kelly Ward in just a second. She'll be joining us. Did you want to do this interview?
I can do it.
All right.
Well, okay.
She's on her way.
I think I'm going over.
Yeah.
One photo, then I'm coming.
She's just wrapping up some photos here.
Thank you. Well, we're
all right.
Thank you. Exactly right.
100%. Dr. Kelly Ward, hi. My name is Mike with Right Side Broadcasting. I don't know if you've heard of us, but we're a conservative.
Yes, I have. All election night, I was saying, thank goodness for Right Side Broadcasting. Thank goodness for the other one, too, OANN.
Right.
But because I wasn't that happy with the election night coverage on some of the mainstream outlets.
What are your thoughts behind why Fox News did this? Like, why would they do this with so much on the line?
Yeah, I have no idea, but we've been urging them to retract, to recant, to pull back on their call of Arizona. Because we are definitely in play. We have hundreds of thousands of votes still to be counted at this moment. And as they're coming in, they're trending for President Trump.
Yeah, and it feels like at this point, if Fox News were to pull a retraction, they could do some serious, it could make a difference
It could make an impact because obviously the media calling this race doesn't really matter. It's all about certifying elections. But the narrative that is out there is that Arizona is blue, and it certainly is not true. We are maintaining almost every Republican seat in this state, if not expanding. And I still think, in my heart, and watching the numbers, watching the science, as Dave Bossi said, Arizona's going for President Donald Trump.
I want to stay with the Fox News thing really quickly. What kind of methods or tactics are being applied to kick up the pressure to Fox News? Because they need to issue a retraction at this point. Wouldn't you agree?
I think they do need to issue a retraction. I think that they're putting a lot of rigmarole out there from their Democrat-run decision desk that is also harmful to the viewer, in a sense, because it's giving them a false sense of reality. Because reality, I'm here on the ground, I can tell you what reality is. Reality is Donald Trump is closing the gap every single hour of the day here in Arizona, and when all is said and done, those votes are going to him, and Arizona's going to be red.
How soon do you think we are to having a decision in Arizona?
You know, I wish it was last night. I wish it was the night before. I wish it would be tonight. I'm not sure. Maybe tomorrow. It's hard to say. It depends on when Maricopa County in particular and when the Secretary of State delivers the count of every legal vote.
And you feel confident that President Trump will carry the state of Arizona?
I do. Of course, I'm a Republican. I'm the Republican Party chairwoman here in Arizona. It's my job to rally the troops and make sure that we do deliver those votes to President Trump. But I personally ask Dr. Kelly Ward, the wife, the mom, the doctor, I believe we're delivering this day for President Trump.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
So it looks like the crowd might be dispersing shortly here. They're going to be going over to the election hall, I guess. And there's going to be gatherings all day into the night with, you know, conservatives, patriots, Trump supporters out here in Phoenix. They're everywhere. We're going to bring you as much live coverage as possible here. Later tonight, as Liz told you, we'll be co-hosting with Mike Cernovich outside of the, what's that building again? I forget.
It's going to be the... The election there. It's got a funky
look. It's got a funky name. That's
just
why I couldn't
stand
get
by. Stand by. We're going to figure this out for
the
you guys.
Maricopa County.
Yep. Can you just hold on to that?
See, guys, we appreciate you supporting us here. We're, as you can tell, we're impromptu. We're unscripted. So every once in a while, we have these little gaffes or, you know, time lapses here. But
tonight
we appreciate you. At the Capitol. It's at the Capitol. Okay, where we were earlier was the Maricopa County thing. But nonetheless, it is absolutely unbelievable that we still don't have an answer in our election. This is just unbelievable. I can't believe it.
There's no end in sight.
And there seems to be no end in sight. Like, we still have, like, 5-6 states that have not given their results yet, and we're just not really sure what's going on, but we're doing our best to bring you guys live coverage of everything happening because we're the only pro-Trump media out here. If you haven't noticed, there are not any other news outlets that are covering the president fairly. They're now asking hard questions. They're asking softball questions. So we're doing our best to bring you guys coverage.
Yeah. Thank you, Mike. We're going to wrap up here shortly. I just want to remind you guys, we are live right now in Phoenix, Arizona. We have another team on their way right now to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and we're currently mobilizing a third team to head to Detroit, Michigan. We're going to cover these press conferences, as many as we can find. And something to note, President Trump has already retweeted our video from today at this press conference at Arizona GOP headquarters. Because mainstream media, once again, is failing to do their job, failing to cover these press conferences in their entirety. So thank you for tuning into RSBN, and hopefully you'll join us. We will be live by 8 p.m. tonight, the steps of the Capitol here in Phoenix, Arizona, bringing you another Stop the Steal rally. Again, Right Side Broadcasting Network, Liz Willis and Mike
Magnificent.
Thank you, and stay tuned for all-day live coverage from across the United States.